Hello everybody, GrayStillPlays, and with this coconut in my hand, that means it's time for more Raft! No time for BS. So, we have some issues here because this pillar is just kind of like standing here in the way, and it's causing a great deal of annoyance for me. So this means that we're going to have to change up the way our structure here is built somewhat. Now there's a couple of ways we could do this. I could just get rid of this pillar and, like, actually that's what I'm going to do. So what I'm going to do real quick is I am going to get rid of this pillar. Just because there's no reason to have it right now. Like, it has our little ceiling here. But, like, the ceiling, like, still works without the pillar, oddly enough. If you remember, the way our tower was built, you kind of just pussyfoot around all the little walls here. Kind of get you up and down and there have you. Works pretty good for that fashion. But realistically, I think I'd want to make it into a double wide, so to speak. Look at how, like, crazy it looks. It's like all sideways and jacked up and such. Like, it's fine the way it is, but I don't know. I feel like it's going to have to look better. That's for damn sure. While we're here, let's take a look at what our inventory looks like. Yeah, it looks like crap. There's Mr. Shark over there just kind of wandering around. I'll give you a little hook for him, see if I can get him. Oh wow, that would have been right on the money, but we're nowhere near close enough to be able to hit him. Inside of the nets, I imagine nothing's really been caught yet. Every time you start the game, the nets get reset. So the nets are pretty much barren here, except for a couple pieces of wood. So that was pretty lucky. A couple more pieces over here. Actually, I'm going to grab all this. A couple pieces of wood to start off the day is never a bad thing. Plus, while we're here, we can... Actually, I'm going to leave those trees there. Let's go ahead and dump the crap that we don't need into our chests. Do we have a bunch more seeds? Yeah, we sure do. We got a whole stack of coconuts on us. So there's no reason to keep those seeds on us because we're going to be using those seeds real fast. I'll put a bunch of metal in there. That's fine. Let's go back over to our tree area that we have created. I'm going to leave that tower be for right now. What we'll do is we'll probably finish up the mansion over here, which is something I've been wanting to do for a little while. Let's go ahead and start hacking down all these trees. Get all the wood that's inside. Oh, sweet, delicious wood. We always need plenty of wood. I like the fact, again, that the coconuts just get stuck in between all of these little tree areas. It makes grabbing them so much easier. Now, there's a potential for the coconuts to fall into the water, like, way on the side like this, but it's really not that bad. I care more about getting struck in the noggin with coconuts than I do about, like, losing them, because I have so many. We've got, oops, see one right there trying to run away from me. Oh, I got him just before it went off the corner! We've got probably, what, like, 40 or 50 coconuts, probably even more. Every single time we go in here, how many are in here? How many trees do we have in here? 25? I don't know, there's quite a bit, but... Regardless, every time we go in here, we could potentially get like 100 coconuts. I don't even know if I'm gonna grab them anymore. Realistically, we're probably only gonna take down half of these. Oh, shark. How are you doing? Oh, wow. Oh, look at that. Came right over by me. And now he's somewhere else? Where are you going, buddy? Maybe going for the nets or something like that? I don't know. Let's continue to get some wood, though. Getting a bunch of this wood... Once I get it, I'm probably going to make a bunch of things into ropes just to get us a little bit more of our inventory space open. And then what we'll do is we'll go ahead and finish. Oh, shit. We're already out of space. See how that works? Oh, wow. All right. Hold on. Let's see if I can sneak my way through here. Oh, this is going to be interesting. I don't know what'll happen. Oh, look at this. All right, put a foundation right there. So I wonder what would happen if a foundation under one of these trees got eaten, and the tree stayed up, but that's probably because there's several foundations holding this tree up. I mean, the foundation is only like a little tiny section of the overall size of the tree, I don't know what this is called, the tree plot, I think it was. Let me go check here. What is this? Tree crop plot. So it's only a tiny little subsection of that. Let's go ahead and make ourselves... Shit, that's not what I wanted to do at all. I just made myself a whole crap load of tree crop plots. Well, you know what? Hold on. That's actually not a bad thing. I'm going to put those over inside of one of our chests. The reason why is because the crop plots are pretty difficult to make, and it's a lot of resources to make each one. So that's something that you'd want to keep inside of your chests like this, because that's pretty much worth something, I would say. Get rid of those damn potatoes because they're not doing anything for me. For the water and the food, got plenty of coconuts right there. We're back in action. All right, we've got a good amount of wood on us, which means we could pretty much fix up the rest of this area up here. Now, if you remember, we started our kind of like deck going around the outside of this giant ass mansion, and I do like that. So let's go ahead and continue with the flooring here. Floors can go out this way, and we can get one more over here, which is pretty nice. So now we have this staircase that goes out, and then, hold on a second, let's see, this is going to be the exit over here from our staircase. So what we can do is we could wall this in, because I feel weird having like this wall just sitting here. It doesn't feel realistic. I mean, not that any of this thing is pretty realistic. There we go. Now it's nice and walled in. So there's a little exit. Now it's got a decent patio out here. Now the big thing is that I don't think that we can get a piece of floor over here. We could put another beam over here. I don't know if I want to do that though. Like, we could put one beam over there. That would get the flooring that we need. We could put another beam over here, but that's kind of weird. I don't know. I might put a beam over here. It's not like we're really using this for anything other than to kind of like have a little lookout. The other thing that we could do if we wanted to is we could start making rooms up here. I think I hear that shark chewing on something, that son of a bitch. I know you guys have said before that a lot of times when I start talking about the shark, he appears in the strangest of places, just kind of being all angry and shark-like and such about his life, because he can't really do very much besides terrorize my floor planks. He certainly is no match for me and my mighty spear. I feel like the shark is too powerful now. I know before in the game, the shark, like, he died really fast. Like, I think you stabbed him 9 times and he was pretty much dead. Now I think the shark's a little bit too annoyingly powerful, because it takes forever to kill this bastard. I'm gonna go ahead and extend this outward. I'm going to put another pillar over here so I can start building upward, and we'll be able to extend the size of this flooring over here all the way over, and that's gonna be pretty nice. While we're at it, let's go ahead and build the foundation out one more, just so that nothing can attack this pillar and cause everything to come down. I know someone was saying that they wanted to see what it was like when one of the pillars got destroyed, all the destruction that would befall our poor settlement. Really nothing happens. It just kind of like miraculously disappears. I don't know what else to say. So let's go ahead and grab the flooring and we can get straight into this. Oh yeah, there we go. Having so much more space is going to be nice. And if we want to, I don't want to do this. Ooh. Maybe I will mess with this a little bit. I'm thinking about taking this piece out and putting it. How do I want to mess with this over here? I could extend us over to the side a little bit. I haven't done that. And we do have plenty of room to do that. So this is actually going to be a bigger tower than I had anticipated because of the way I'm starting to do things. But that's fine. We'll do that. No big deal. Let's go ahead and do the flooring then. Right over here, we can start bringing our floors. Let's see here, one over that way. Yeah, we'll be fine. Oh, for the love of God. How many coconuts does it take to keep this girl satisfied? All the coconuts, that's the answer. All right, pillar down, floors are going up. There we go. That's gonna extend the overall size of all of our stuff, which is pretty nice. I may even make another pillar in back just so that we can extend the rear end of this place. In fact, I think I'm going to do that for sure. Okay, so yeah, our platform is suddenly going to be much, much larger than I had previously anticipated. It's going to be like another giant mansion, in fact. All right, that's fine, though. Going to end up using a lot of wood, but that's good because we've created essentially what is a forest over here. So, oh, I hear something. What do I hear? Do I hear a shark messing around? Like I said, our village is so large at this point that I can't even hear the shark when he starts chewing on shit. We just start losing things. There he is way over there. We have, yep, right there. I see a net down right away. Go ahead and grab some of these things. That should easily get us the resources that we're going to need to make a net. Oh, the nets are so easily made right now because we have so many things on us. There we go. Boom. Nets for days. Already done. Go across all of these little areas here. Oop, hold on. Let me bounce our way out. What don't I care about? We can take a bunch of the palms and turn those into ropes. Get rid of those. Get rid of all this. I'm just going to get rid of a bunch of this scrap because we're not going to need it. Now, I can start grabbing these planks here. I think that that's just about everything. Oh, there's a whole, wow, there's a whole bushel of planks over here. I don't think that that's the appropriate word for it. I don't think it's a bushel, but whatever. Trees are growing over there. I planted a whole slew of new trees, so they're kind of going up and doing their thing, looking pretty good. Someone mentioned, how high can you get this? And I think they said that someone made it like 72 layers high. I don't think I'll ever get that high. I don't know if I have the tenacity to do something like that. Well, no, I don't think I have the tenacity to do something like that. I thought about it for a second. Right there. You can see him in the distance. I just saw him eating my freaking stairs. Or not my stairs. My freaking nets right there. I saw it from way downtown, baby. Eagle Eyes Gray. That's what I'm talking about. Let's go ahead and put one of these. Where do I want this pillar at? I could put it here and extend. Yeah, our overall size will be pretty magnificent if I put it there. I just have to worry about having more foundations out. So, well, for right now, I'm going to do this. That'll just save us some wood so I can get upstairs and start messing with this. Let's start putting the flooring down if we can. Only reason I did it like that is so that it'll protect those pillars. Oh, yeah. We still have 28 pieces. Oh, we got plenty here. There we go. Now I can go upstairs without seeming like I'm falling off the edge of the earth. That's kind of nice. The only question is, what do I want to do with the rest of the stairs like this? I don't really care to bring it out. So I think what I'm going to do is put it that way. So like we'll keep kind of going up the same direction because I don't want to make it higher this away. I don't think. I don't know, like, when I make these plans, I don't really have the plans to begin with. I just kind of start spontaneously building stuff. That's why I'm a terrible builder. I just kind of do my thing and I have fun doing it. That's all. Let's see here. Yeah, we can do this. Hold on 1 second while I kind of mess around a little bit real fast. All right, get two pillars down here. Start putting the... Oh, shit. I know you got... Someone said I still have two floors that are, like, facing the wrong direction or something like that. I'm never going to figure out where they are. So, we're going to have to just deal. But the rest of this I could put appropriately up. Let's see here. Do this over here. Did I just... Hold on. Let me put that over that way. And do I want to build all the way out? Yeah, I guess I might as well. We've got just enough floors to finish this portion off. We're going to have to build the rest of the way up. Thing I was going to ask was, did I put that floor down too high? Okay, no, good. I can still get up here, so it's no big deal. More coconuts for the horde. Hold on. Let me go ahead and choke down some quick coconuts. That should get our drink mostly up. Yeah, we're pretty good. So what I'm going to have to do is cut down even more trees so that we can continue building upward. And this thing is going to get very, very tall indeed. It's going to be at least 4 levels of a decent sized place. It's not going to be mansion sized like this, but it's almost going to be there, man. And then from this watchtower, I don't know what we'll do from there. Maybe we will build out to the edge of the zone. Actually, you know what? I haven't built out to the edge of the zone yet. I kind of want to know what it's like. Maybe we'll go from one of our nets. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Hold on. We're going to build out to the edge of the zone real quick. I want to know exactly how much space I get. Man, the tree growing simulator is real. I turned my back for 5 minutes and all these trees are already fully mature. I'll tell you, it sure makes getting the planks easy. That's for damn sure. But the biggest thing is, I don't know, man. I wish, I mean, the inventory is already pretty big, but this is a very, very crafty, heavy game. Like, you need several planks to make damn near anything, except for, I think, the floors. And, I mean, you know, when it comes to, like, just, like, the different crafting materials. So I kind of wish that the stacks were bigger, like more Minecraft-y level of big. Like maybe, I don't know, maybe we could have like, just something bigger than 10. I don't know. I don't know what the appropriate amount is, but just more than 10. We're already throwing stuff out of here. I'm going to get rid of this thatch. I don't need all this right now. I do want, of course I get more thatch. There we go. Planks. That's what I want. More planks. I'll grab a couple of, can I even grab any more coconuts? No, I can't. Let's go ahead and put a coconut down here. Reason why is because we can start eating them. And then I can refill it with coconuts just laying on the ground. You see, right now we're at 7 coconuts. But that's, quite frankly, not enough. 1, 2, 3. And we're back to good. I'll drink one more because I think we have one more coconut just laying around, don't we? But there's always coconuts just kind of wandering all over the place in this freaking raft. I'll tell you what. There we go. Let's go ahead and plant our seeds again just to kind of get everything good and proper. How are we doing plank-wise? Yeah, we're doing okay. Okay. So we got all the planks that we're going to need. Now all I need to do is go over to our net area and start putting down a ton of nets. And we will build out to one side of the zone here just to see what happens when we get there. It has begun. Nets are going down, baby. Nets are going down. We could also just build regular foundations, I guess. Well, actually, hold on. What does it take? For a net, it takes 3 ropes and 2 planks of wood. And then what does it take for just like a regular foundation here? It takes 2 and 1. Okay, well, I guess we can do that. Hold on. Which way are all these foundations facing? That way. Okay. Figure I would do it this way. All right, baby. Here we go. Let's start building outward. Excuse me, shark. Well, I just learned something interesting. The distance on the... Oh, shit. Hold on. Let me go ahead and fix this real quick. Come on. Get your ass out of here. I guess I should probably repair that since I don't know what sort of horrible things will befall us if it doesn't get repaired. Can I repair this? The hell did you attack? What? Nothing's injured. This is weird. All right. Well, anyway, what I wanted to show you guys was when you're taking down a tree, watch this. Hold on. Let me get over here. All right. So see, there's a tree over there. I had no idea that the distance on the hatchet was this large. Oh my God. I mean, can I hit these things from across the way? Hold on. Right here, right? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Look at this. Hold on. If that tree goes down, then I have been doing... All right. No, I don't think... I think you have to be closer than this. So what distance are you allowed to be? Oh, right about here. Look at this. You about be about 3 planks away and you could strike freaking trees. That's crazy. I had no idea that you could be this far away. This is hilarious. Look, from all the way over here, I could stand in the center and probably get all those trees. I don't even have to walk around anymore. I'm becoming more and more lazy. That's how it goes. I kind of wonder too. I'm starting to see how I want to feel with this place. If I want to build an even larger grove or what. No matter what, I think that we're kind of coming to the end of the old raft series. There's only so much that we could do. And unfortunately, I just don't know when the rest of the... When the rest of the updates are going to come. Or even if there are going to be any updates. So what you get is you get an instance where kind of all I could really do is just piddle around and kind of like mess around with what we've got. I could build like, I don't know, like a freaking Mickey Mouse head or something like that out of all the planks. But I just don't have enough creativity to do it. Well, I have the drive. I just don't have the artistic ability, I should say. I'll tell you something. If there's one thing old Gray doesn't have, it is any artistic ability at all. Let's go ahead and put some ropes together, though, because if there's one thing I can do, it is build a bunch of foundations to the edge of the planet over here. Man, you can get pretty damn far. Okay, so that's not enough planks. Holy crap. So if you wanted to, man, you could build a hell of a raft. I mean, it would take you a while. I guess I could really buckle down and get this thing built as big as possible, but holy shit, if I'm still building foundations that way, how far out have we gone now? Well, at least what? At least 10 or 15? Jesus Christ. Hold on, let me get some more... Oh, that's right, I don't have to go that close. Let me get some more thatch. Well, boys, this looks pretty familiar, doesn't it? That's because the game crashed, and it didn't save any of the work I just did. Oh, well, the game is like a prototype. Like, this isn't even alpha. This is like... prototype, they just messed around, put some of the assets in here so that we could use them, and you know, they built a game out of it, but obviously there's still a couple of bugs and stuff like that. I'll say though, for not having any real like bug fixing instances, like they've hotfixed some stuff and they fixed some bugs and stuff like that. That was really the first crash I've ever had that forced me to go backwards. So, realistically, I think that the game is pretty solid as a game. I really hope that they kind of go back to developing it, though. I know they're in school and they're doing stuff like that, and they're really focused at trying to complete their studies. I think that's a good idea, but they had a really cool game here. I think that if they can keep upgrading it and keep things coming, just new different items to craft, I think that they can really expand this into something that's pretty damn cool. Anyway, folks, that's going to be it for right now. I may get off camera and build this stuff up again so you guys don't have to watch me do it a second time. I certainly wouldn't want to put you guys through that. And I'm not really sure what else I want to do. So like I said, Raft may be slowly just kind of fading away. That doesn't mean that it's the end. It just means that for now I'm going to have to think of better things to do. Because realistically, it is my duty to bring you guys decent content that has value to it. Now, I know some people are saying, but Gray, your content never has any value. Well, whatever. You know, I try and put something there. I don't know if I could teach any life lessons or anything like that. But if nothing else, it's just you and me getting to spend a little bit of time together, which I enjoy. And I really am honored that you guys take the time to share that time with me. So, anyway, folks, hope you enjoyed this episode of Raft. Until the next time, stay foxy and much love.